Hello, this is Jacob Lewis at Blue Lotus Media, and today I wanted to show you my top 10 favorite plugins that I find myself using again and again whenever I do websites for clients. So, without further ado, my number one favorite plugin right now is Page Builder by Siteorigin. So I'm just going to go here, go to Plugins, type Page Builder. And there it is right there. You can see it has a million plus active installs because it's awesome. It's actually a whole collection of widgets and page building functionality that it adds into WordPress. And it just makes life so easy. Even if you're a developer, I mean, plugins just save you so much time. So then I click install now. And that's that, and then I activate it. This is one of the reasons I love WordPress so much, is because of the huge database of open source plugins. And I mean, I code as well, but it would take me so much longer to do websites if I didn't have access to all of these. So, along with Page Builder goes this widget bundle, which I recommend installing to get the most out of it. So I didn't even count this as one in the top 10 because it's just kind of a necessity with this plugin. So widget bundle, site, origin. It's this one. 600,000 installs. Alright, we're going to activate that. I'm going to get into more of how to use each of these plugins in later videos, but this is just an overview of some of my top picks. So number two is Mailpoet. Now this is a great plugin for collecting email subscribers, and you can send out emails through your own hosting, or you can connect it to MailChimp or one of the other big companies like that to manage it, which as your list grows, you'll definitely want to do at some point once it gets above like 2,000 or 3,000. So we're just going to type Mailpoet here. And click install. And activate. This plugin's great because it allows you to make really customized looking professional newsletters with a drag and drop interface. And you can even create autoresponder sequences if you want, or you can have it send out automatic daily or weekly digests. And yeah, it's a great plugin. I mean, newsletter subscribers are so important for traffic generation these days. Okay, my number three pick is Animate It. Now this is just fun for adding. I like to use it in a subtle way so that as people are scrolling, sometimes different page elements move or fade in or slide in, or it's not really necessary, but it's a nice little, it depends on the site how you use it. Some sites it makes more sense to use it than others. It helps to also draw attention to important elements if you're going to use it in like a usability sense. So just going to install that and activate. Now I'm going to go to custom contact forms. A lot of people use Contact Form 7, and I used to use that as well. But I prefer custom contact forms now, mostly because I had a clash with Contact Form 7 and the BuddyPress plugin when I was trying to do a small social network a while back. If you're not doing anything with BuddyPress, then you'll probably be fine. And you can even go in and edit the code, or maybe they've fixed it since then. But custom contact forms is incredibly flexible, and I really like it. So I'm just going to look that up here. Install. It's really cool because you can actually easily integrate Google's reCAPTCHA to verify that people aren't robots. Prevent spam coming through. And you can make multiple forms, and there's all kinds of fun features to play with, and you can have email notifications sent out or all sorts of stuff. It's pretty powerful. So my number five pick is WP Canvas Gallery. Now this is currently my favorite image gallery plugin. Free one anyway. WP Canvas Gallery. I spent a lot of time researching all these plugins, and I mean, there's a lot of options out there and it can be really overwhelming. So it's just a lot of trial and error, activating, deactivating different things. And I really found that WP Canvas Gallery provided all the flexibility I needed in a free plugin. And it's also super easy to update, so clients can add their own galleries or manage their galleries with no problem. So I'm going to install that and activate it. And now on to number six, which is Yoast SEO. Everyone can use a little SEO boost these days, especially since Google updated its algorithm and everyone's SEO just dropped off the deep end, except for really reputable brands. It's difficult now to break through. You just have to have the most relevant content out there, and there's a lot of competition. It's growing all the time. But this plugin definitely helps to keep things optimized, tell you where you could strengthen things up a little bit. It's a little buggy using it with Page Builder because it doesn't always detect all the content properly, but it still helps, and it gives you some good tips and bullet points to check off. So I recommend it. It also generates a sitemap, which you can submit to Google Console, so you can, you know, more closely monitor the SEO on your site and get recommendations directly from Google. So yeah, it's a great plugin. We're just going to install that. Activate. It's cool because it will also tell you how readable your text is, and sometimes it'll recommend to shorten up your sentences or clean things up a little bit, and it can find errors or ways that you could make your article better. So it's definitely good if you're going to have a blog or something like that, which is also recommended for SEO, is having a blog. This is more of a portfolio site for now, but we may add a blog in later. So my number seven plugin is Page Transitions, or Page Transition, I think. Let me see. One of those. Now, this is just a very subtle, you know, very subtle effect, but I think it makes a difference when people come to your site and it subtly fades in, as opposed to things just appearing haphazardly on the screen, and as it loads, it's kind of nice. It kind of buffers it for a second while everything loads, and then it just fades in smoothly. So if you're working on a site and you want it to look really elegant and clean, then page transition is a cool add-on. So I'm just going to install and activate that. Number 8 is Easy Google Fonts. This is the best plugin I've found for using Google Fonts. It makes it super easy to customize them visually while you're looking at your site through the customize view, and I'll demonstrate that in another video. So, Easy Google Fonts. You can also target custom classes or IDs if you know what you're doing. So if you want to edit a specific font that's not one of the H1 through H6 tags or a paragraph tag, then you can do that. So yes, we're going to install that and activate. And on to number 9. Which is Easy Smooth Scroll Links. I like this plugin because if you have a page where you have a lot of links at the top, or even in like the one page scrolling websites that are really popular right now, super trendy, where instead of going to another page, when you click the link, it just moves you down the page. Well, this plugin just makes that move very smooth instead of like a just jumping to the anchor on the page. They click the link and it will take them down to the specific section that you specify. So I like it. Easy Smooth Scroll Links. We're going to search for that. Easy Smooth Scroll Links. Or ESSL. There it is. And activate. And last but not least is Easy Fancybox. I know three of these last ones all started with the word easy, but this, it really is easy. I mean, you install this plugin, and then if anybody clicks an image on your website that links to the image itself, it will enlarge the image in a Fancybox window. And you don't even have to do any setup. You just activate the plugin, and then it's site-wide. If you link to the media file, it will pop up in a new window. Well, in a Fancybox window with a overlay effect, and there's some customization options. So Easy Fancy Box is very cool. There's another one out there that I like for different purposes, but this will do in most cases. Wait, where is it? Oh, let's try connecting that. Easy Fancy Box, here we go. Now that's my top 10 for this video. There are some other plugins that I really like, such as Facebook Comments or Shareaholic is really nice. Or there's just so many plugins out there, but I wanted to pick my top 10 that I use for almost every single site, and this is what I came up with. So hope this helped, and until next time, I'm Jacob Lewis. And have a great day.